Hey guys, welcome back. So last time I welded this cylinder head here, and if you haven't seen that video, you might want to go check that one out. What I did was I used my MIG to fill in some places where it blew out at the coolant passages, and then I used a wood router to flatten those welds down. So it looks pretty good. Like I said in the last video, I had to make another pass with the welder, so I did that and then came back over again with the router and took a look. There's one place right here where I still got a little bit of an imperfection, but we're going to get rid of that when we flatten this whole cylinder head here. I haven't checked. It's probably pretty flat. Maybe it's warped a little bit, but in either case, we're going to clean it up. There is some like pitting, you know, from where the gasket was and stuff. So this part here, I'm not super happy with how close this passage ended up to the ceiling surface of the combustion chamber. If you look down in there, I think I might have gotten a little bit carried away with the Dremel when I was widening this out, which is stupid because if you look at the gasket, these holes, they're not even completely used. It's just a little teeny like pinhole to let the coolant through. So I didn't even need to grind it out much. But my thought was that if I left the welds how they were, there'd be like places for crap to collect behind there. And, I wanted like a smooth transition. And so this might have actually been a little bit more corroded out to this point anyway. So I wish I had noticed that as I was doing it, but I think it'll be okay. I think it's going to hold at least for a little while. So let me show you how I'm going to flatten this. And I'm going to use my table saw. I'm going to use the cast iron table that's on it. So these cast iron tables were ground flat at the factory, so they're a nice, good reference surface to use. So I just cleaned it up. There's a little bit of surface rust, but it's nothing. It's staining. So I use a little razor blade just to get any like high points off, and then came over with the 3M pad. And an old machinist once told me that your finger can feel a millionth of an inch, which is crazy, but it makes sense if you can feel like a tiny little hair and just the things that you can perceive. So this feels pretty good to me. So we're going to use some 3M spray adhesive here. This is called Super 77, and it's just a like a spray contact adhesive kind of thing. And then I've got some 80 grit sandpaper, and we're going to put this down. And I'm not sure, the back of this stuff has kind of like a tacky kind of surface on it. I might be able to get away with, let's see. Oh yeah. Yeah, I don't need to spray the back of the sandpaper either. That sticks really well. Yeah. The important thing is that they don't overlap, of course. There can be a little bit of a gap, that's fine. So here's the idea, and let me get that last piece on, and basically just gonna rub the cylinder head against it until it's all cleaned up. Let's give it a shot. So you might not know, but I know this from woodworking. You can actually take a flat surface and sandpaper and a flat piece, and end up putting a curve into it. If you're not careful with how you put pressure into the piece, this thing is pretty heavy, so it's easy to just kind of rock it back and forth. So I'm not too worried about that, but it is possible if you were, say, like leaning on one side more than the other, you could actually sand off one side more, and then it ends up not being flat. So the key here is to just kind of like let the weight of this thing do it, you know, help you out, and just apply horizontal forces, and try not to push down on it at all. Yeah, you can see, I don't know if you can see, I can see, that this end and up over here kind of getting a little bit more scratches in it than some places in the middle, you know, like right here, you can see that must have been a low point, so it is warped a little bit. So it's good we're doing this. This will get it all down to a flat surface. And I'm going to clean the sandpaper often. This stuff is just actually just brushing right off. The vacuum would be good here. And maybe a dust mask. We're getting there. All right, well, you get the idea. Oh. That's what it's looking like. It's a lot of elbow grease, but that's how it goes when you don't have a mill. Someday. So I'm gonna have to keep doing this, but it's getting late and I gotta get ready for work. So that's gonna be the end of this video. I'm not sure though, I was planning on coming back with 120 grit sandpaper, but you know, they don't sand it from the machine shop. You know, they just leave a machine surface. I'm thinking this 80 grit's even smoother than we need really for a gasket surface. And in fact, I think you do want like a little bit of a bite for the gasket to seal properly. So yeah, I've got a little bit more here to go. There's still some corrosion here I want to get down to. So it's clean now and it's pretty flat and it's probably be fine, but I do want to just get rid of a little bit more, make this all bright metal. So, all right. So then after that, I got to clean the whole thing. I haven't figured out the best way to clean it yet. Probably just brushes and acetone or something. It's probably going to be a very manual process, but I wish I had some kind of tank to dip it in of, not water this time, but some kind of solvent or something. And then even before I do that, maybe I'm going to clean up the valves and make sure that the valves are clean up the seats and the guides and make sure the valves still sit in here properly and that I didn't like warp it. Because if that's the case, then I got to go bring and have a valve job done, which is some money I didn't want to spend. And I might end up just buying an aftermarket head at that point if it comes to that. So but we'll see. All right, a little bit long-winded, but thanks for watching. I hope you found this somewhat interesting, and if it helped you at all, let me know in the comments. If you think this is stupid, let me know that in the comments too. I always like to hear those, honestly. So it's good to hear from you guys. All right,
Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.